Blake Griffin re-signs with the Los Angeles Clippers. This seems like a Clippers move to do. But hey, you got to sign your third best player in franchise history because you just traded away your second best one. Yes, Elton Brand is the best Clipper of all time. Fight me over that. But when it comes down to it, the Clippers trading for Blake, re-signing Blake Griffin and trading away Chris Paul just reassured one thing. They are fine with just being mediocre. They are fine just having the attraction, but not being a star. And yes, even though the Lakers, they're sucking now. Let's just be real here. At this point in time, Lonzo Ball is a bigger star than Blake Griffin. With all the crap that LaVar Ball's doing, and all the hype that Lonzo Ball has been getting, and the way that Blake Griffin has been playing with all these injuries and everything like that, Lonzo Ball is a bigger star. And soon the Lakers will once again be big brothers, while the Clippers, they'll always prove why they were the mediocre little brothers to the Los Angeles Lakers. You trade away Chris Paul, who is a respectable guy in the league, to a lot of players. Yes, maybe he does he whine on the court a lot? Yeah, he does. But he's a respectable player, and a player that a lot of teams and executives respect. And you go on and you trade him, and you feel like, oh, maybe the Clippers are going to go on a full-on rebuild. But then they go on and they throw this huge money at Blake Griffin, and I say to myself, why? I don't really hear a lot of players talking about how they want to play with Blake Griffin. When it comes to Blake Griffin, I don't think Blake Griffin's a bad basketball player whatsoever. I think he's really good. He's good, and he's improved every single year that he's played. I just feel like, to be honest here, when it comes down to it, it doesn't seem like Blake Griffin's a great teammate. Like I said, how many free agents are you hearing saying, I want to play with Blake Griffin. I'm going to go to the Clippers to play with Blake Griffin. I've never really heard that. I never really heard people are talking about playing with Blake Griffin. And I thought Jimmy Butler, a guy that I always said was probably not someone that I believe is a huge locker room leader. And, you know, my opinion is still out there on Jimmy Butler. And I do like that Jimmy Butler's on the Timberwolves. Don't get me twisted. But, you know, the guy like Jimmy Butler, who I talked about, is kind of like I always felt was a psychopath and someone that I felt like, you know, didn't get along with teammates. He drove Derrick Rose out of Chicago, and there was friction between him and Fred Hoiberg, and him and Dwayne Wade had their own little clique, and he lost kind of the locker room in Chicago type of deal. But, and especially when I heard Rajon Rondo praise Jimmy Butler and wants to play with him more, I'm just saying to myself, oh my God, if Rondo likes you, you got to be some sort of psychopath. I'm still hearing that players want to play with Jimmy Butler and people respect Jimmy Butler and they want to sign with Minnesota so they can be with Jimmy Butler. But with Blake Griffin, I'm not hearing any players saying, oh, I want to go be with Blake Griffin. J.J. Redick is not like, oh, well, Blake Griffin's back. Okay, I'm going to re-sign with the Clippers. No, he's looking to find a way down to H-Town and play with his good buddy Chris Paul. That's what Blake Griffin's doing. I mean, that's what J.J. Redick's planning on doing. Really, to be honest here, when it comes down to it, Blake Griffin, the Clippers signing Blake Griffin to this contract, it just shows that they're settling for mediocrity and they just want to be mediocre. Yeah, they will always be in the playoffs in the West as long as Blake Griffin's healthy enough. And that's the question, is he going to be healthy enough? Because the one thing about Blake Griffin, as of late in his career, he's been always getting these injuries and also at crucial times in the season. For the Los Angeles Clippers, when they really need him the most. It always feels like when Blake Griffin's hitting his stride and he's looking like a different type of player, he always suffers this injury that holds him back. And it's just like, yeah, you know, injuries happen at any time and at any time during the sport. But still, it's like, you're really going to give to someone 5 years, $172 mil, your supermax, to a guy that, you know, yeah, he improves every year he's in the league. Yeah, he's a really good player, arguably a top 30, top 20 type of player. Just depends on your view on it. He's the third best player in your organization because you traded away your second best player, and Elton Brand deserves a statue outside of Staples Center. Fight me over that. I don't care. When it comes down to it, with the Clippers, I just don't know with Blake Griffin how much is going to really change the team and make them go over the hump and say, oh, well, Chris Paul, he was the problem. We re-signed Blake, and now we're going to sign a bunch of other mediocre role players. I just don't see how this helps the Clippers, and I don't see how this makes the Clippers a good team whatsoever. I just feel like the Clippers are just settling with mediocrity, and that must suck if you're a Clippers fan, because trust me, I know what it's like when a team wants to just settle for just mediocrity. But anyways, what do you guys think about the Clippers re-signing Blake Griffin? Personally, me, I'm not a fan. Like I said, I think Blake Griffin's a really good player. I just feel like with the Clippers, if you were going to have it where you traded away your second best player in franchise history, I just feel it was time for you guys to rebuild, especially if you want to try to build off like young assets, because Blake Griffin's not going to help you get those young assets you want for the future. Blake Griffin's going to just help you win a couple more games, get you in the playoffs, and then disappoint you guys when you don't win it all or you don't make it far enough. But how funny would it be, though, if the Clippers made the Western Conference Finals and Chris Paul wasn't on the team? That'd be pretty funny. But I don't see that happening. Anyways, guys, please comment down below what you guys think about Blake Griffin re-signing with the Los Angeles Clippers. Do you think he should have went somewhere else? If you guys like what I said here, give this video a big old thumbs up. And if you didn't like what I said, just give this video a big old thumbs down. It doesn't matter to me. All opinions are welcome here on the Chase Lava channel. I'll see you guys later for more NBA free agency madness. I know, a bunch of videos being uploaded to this channel, but I hope you guys enjoy each and one of them. Enjoy the rest of your day, guys. Peace.